Hello and welcome to Simplified on PowerDrift, where we take complicated automotive ideas and break them down into something you can use in your life with motorcycles. Today we're talking about tire tread, what it is, what it does, and why you should really pay attention to it. Before we go ahead, please do hit the subscribe button, the bell notification icon, and the share button. So, tire tread. The word tread on a tire refers to the part of the tire which is usually in contact with the ground where you normally see a pattern. But it doesn't always have to be a pattern, right? Because if you see racing slicks on one side, they have no pattern at all. Whereas on the other side, racing wet tires have a lot of patterning going on, and off-road tires have a completely different kind of pattern altogether. But 99% of the time, the job of the tread is just one, which is to eliminate as much water as possible between the tire and the road surface. Any water that gets in there can A, sort of work like a lubricant and reduce the amount of grip you've got, or B, if there's enough water between the tire and the road, it'll remove the contact entirely, a concept we call aquaplaning, which I can do a simplified about. If you'd like to know more about aquaplaning, leave us a comment. But aquaplaning is a situation where the tire no longer touches the ground, and at that point you have no control over the vehicle at all. And the tread's job is to delay the onset of aquaplaning as much as possible. How does it do this? If you look at the pattern on the tread, we're going to primarily talk about two surfaces, the one on top, which touches the road actually, and the one at the bottom, which doesn't ever touch the road until the tire wears out. Let's call these the positive surface and the negative surface, just for convenience. Now, the positive surface's job is effectively what the tire is supposed to do, which is transfer your control inputs to the road so that the vehicle responds in the way that you want it to. Which means, when I accelerate, the positive surface actually bends. Hysteresis is the official word, and the hysteresis and the friction allows you to move the vehicle forward when you open the throttle. When you use the brakes, exactly the reverse of this happens, where again, the positive surface in contact with the ground will deform, and that will allow your braking input to be turned into retardation. It's the same when you turn the vehicle's handlebar as well. It's the same when you turn a steering wheel in a car as well. That's what the positive surface does. What the negative surface does is give a channel to the water so that the pressure of the positive surface diverts the water into the negative channels, and these channels allow the water to exit the scene rather than get between the positive surface and the road that it is touching. In a sense, that's what a tread does. But tread designs can be optimized so that they make less noise, because treaded tires do make a lot of road noise, and if you design them badly, you'll hear it as a drone, and a lot of off-road tires on the road will make a lot of noise, because noise is not a criteria that is used to design tread for off-road tires. Right? So quietness is one function of the tread. If you make the negative channels too big and the positive channels are in very, very small blocks, then these blocks can bend. And if they bend, then you'll also feel it as a little bit of an instability on the vehicle, because every time you put a control input, that block is actually twisting around a little bit and not giving you a feeling of stability, right? Tread can also have sipes, which are extremely narrow channels. You'll usually see them on really low performance vehicles because they have the time to use the sipe to evacuate water, whereas a fast moving vehicle will just not give the sipes enough time to do anything. Therefore, high performance tires will have some amount of tread, but they may not have a lot of sipes at all. Also, as you go up the performance ladder and the vehicles get faster, the presumption is that the wetter it gets, the less chances that you'll be outside with those tires. And those tires on the edges of the tire where you're doing very serious cornering will not have any tread at all, because the presumption is you will not use the motorcycle at that lean angle in the wet at all, so it doesn't need tread there. But it'll have some tread in the middle area of the tire where you're going more or less in a straight line or at relatively modest lean angles, and there is some amount of work needed to get water out from between the road and the tire. Why we need to pay attention to the tread is because when a tire is new, there is quite a difference in the height between the top of the positive surface and the bottom of the negative surface. This channel is the amount of volume there is into which water can go and exit the situation. As the tire wears out, the positive top and the negative bottom come closer and closer together, which means that the size of the channel is reducing. The amount of water that the tire can remove from the situation starts to reduce as the tire wears out. This is why you have TWIs, or tire wear indicators, which are slightly raised ribs that sit at the bottom of the negative channels. And the idea is when the rib and the top of the positive surface come to the same level, you need to get rid of the tire. And usually this rib will be about 1 mm from the bottom. And that's why they also say if you take a 1 rupee coin, stick it in the tread, and the top of the positive surface touches the bottom of the number one, you need to get rid of the tire. Because at that point, the negative channels have reached a point where it is no longer possible for this tire to do its job in the wet. So, first reason to pay attention to the tread is obviously from the perspective of tire wear. And if you're out in the wet, then this tire needs to do its job and support you as you try to brake, as you try to accelerate, and as you try to turn. And a worn tire will not be able to do this for you. When you go to the off-road situation, the job that a tread has to do actually changes quite a bit. Remember, a road doesn't deform, right? So the tire is sitting there on top of the road, deforming and allowing you to perform the acceleration, the deceleration, and the turning. But an off-road surface presumes that the surface itself is not stable. And now the tread's job is literally to dig into that surface and then propel you forward. Which is why off-road tires have knobs, which are effectively like hooks. And these hooks are supposed to penetrate the surface and push the motorcycle forward, allow you to turn and give you grip. These tires will always make a lot of noise because of the design of the tire. And here you'll see that the negative channels are larger because here the job is not to evacuate the water, but give a chance for the positive blocks to actually dig into the surface and move you forward. Even there, once the difference comes smaller and smaller and smaller, the hook is not going as deep into the surface anymore, and therefore the amount of grip that you're going to enjoy from the off-road tire will fall. And in both cases, what I'm fundamentally saying is the less tread depth you have, the worse your tire will feel, either in the wet or off-road, depending on what kind of tire you're using. Now let's talk about the one thing we've not talked about, which is why does a racing slick not have any tread pattern at all? Now remember, the tread's job is only to evacuate water from between the tire and the road. And a dry racing slick presumes that you're in a dry condition going as fast as you can. There is no water in this situation, so it doesn't need tread. Because the larger the positive surface is, the more power I can transfer, the more confidently I can turn the motorcycle and brake the motorcycle. When you maximize this, you get a tread pattern that has no negative channels at all, a racing slick. But the presumption and the reason why you will never use a racing slick out on the public road is because when a racetrack gets wet, a racer will simply drive 2 or 3 kilometers back into pit lane and get a completely different kind of tire and go back out again. So, in sum, your tread's job is to remove water from between the tire and the road so that you can continue to perform acceleration, deceleration, and turning on a motorcycle. The reason to pay attention to tread depth is because as the depth gets less, the amount of water we can remove becomes less, which means the amount of grip you will have available starts to become less and less and less, to the point where it'll become zero. And the reason why we say you change your tire when 1 mm of tread depth is left is because you never want the situation to hit zero. Thank you so much for watching. That's all you need to know about tread depth, really. This is Simplified on Powerdrift, where we break complicated ideas into small bits that you can use in your life with motorcycles. If you'd like to discuss this in more detail, leave us a comment. If there's other aspects of a tire that you'd like us to talk about, leave us a comment. We already have a Simplified on how to read the numbers on the side of the tire, for example. Please do go see that. And if there's other topics, anything at all automotive that needs to be discussed, leave us a comment and we'll get right on it. Thank you so much for watching.